Good morning, children. We will start with lesson 7, that is life under a microscope. Now, children, we use microscope to see such things which we cannot see with our naked eyes, right? So the small organisms, the unicellular organisms, can be observed using a microscope. So in this chapter, we will study about all the living organisms which can be observed under a microscope. It is very important to know about a Dutch scientist named Antony van Leeuwenhoek. He was the first person who observed living cells under a simple microscope that he made himself. Okay, so he made a simple microscope and then he took a drop of pond water and he observed it under the simple microscope, and he was the first person who observed the living cells under the microscope. Alright, you all know that pond water, if I take a drop of pond water, it must be having many microbes. So Antony van Leeuwenhoek was the first person who observed it. So he is responsible for discovering microbes. Okay, he discovered microbes in a drop of water. Now, those organisms that cannot be seen with the naked eye and can only be observed through a microscope are called microorganisms. The science which deals with the study of microbes, it is known as microbiology, and the scientists who study microbes, they are called microbiologists. Now, where do the microbes live? Children, microbes can be found everywhere. Okay, they are around us, in the air that we are breathing in. They are inside our body. They can be found inside animals' body. Then they can be found in water, soil, everywhere. They are also found in dead and decaying organisms. Some microbes, they act as decomposers. This you have already studied. So they are found in every kind of environment, in sea, lake, ponds, hot deserts, etc. So microbes are well adapted. Different types of microbes will be found in different types of environmental situations. Scientists have classified the microbes into 5 major groups. So on the basis of the type of microbe, we can classify them into 5 types: bacteria, virus, algae, fungi, and protozoa. This activity, children, is there in your book. You see this: to observe microbes in pond water. The first image is of a compound microscope. This is a light microscope which is very easily found in each and every laboratory. Okay, so at the top there is eyepiece and then there are some objective lens in the middle. So the slide which is containing the sample is kept on this black disc and then it is observed from the top. Now they have simply taken a drop of pond water. This time, like you remember, as I told you, Antony van Leeuwenhoek, he used his simple microscope. Now we have this light compound microscope. So if we use this to observe a drop of pond water, then we will observe many bacteria, many microbes there in that drop of water. As you can see, the image that is on the right hand side. Okay, so this is a magnified image of a drop of water. So here many microbes are there, small. Many microbes. Okay, major groups of microorganisms. Now children, some microbes, they have a tendency to live alone and some will be found together, that is in colonies. Okay, so and some microbes are unicellular, some are multicellular, and some are colonial. Their existence is always together, colonial. ओके मैनी माइक्रोब्स विल बी देयर टुगेदर सराउंडेड बाय अ स्लाइमी लेयर और समथिंग सो दैट दे कैन लिव टुगेदर दे स्टिक टुगेदर सो देयर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ माइक्रोब्स अ लॉट ऑफ वेराइटी कैन बी फाउंड इन द वर्ल्ड ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स सम एग्जाम्पल्स आर गिवन हियर यूनिसेलुलर माइक्रोब्स एग्जाम्पल्स बैक्टीरिया इन एल्गी क्लेमाइडोमोनास क्लोरेला दीज आर द टू एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ यूनिसेलुलर एल्गी देन ईस्ट इज अ फंजाई विच इज यूनिसेलुलर In protozoans, amoeba, paramecium, euglena are examples of unicellular protozoans. So, there are many protozoans and you have already studied about these three types in class 6 in classification of animals. Okay, and you know that protozoans are very primitive, simple unicellular organisms. So, these are examples of unicellular microbes. Then, multicellular microorganisms in algae, Spirogyra. As the name suggests, this algae is spiral shaped. Then rhizopus. Rhizopus is bread mold. This is multicellular. Colonial microorganisms. Example is given Volvox. It comes under algae and Volvox has a tendency to live together. Alright, so these examples are very important. You should know at least one example of each type. Moving on to bacteria. Now, bacteria are among the smallest and the most primitive organisms found on earth. Primitive, you all know, very ancient, very old. Okay, their existence chronologically, if you see, they are very, very old. Okay, they have been there since ages on planet Earth. The size of bacterial cells varies from 0.2 to 100 microns. This is written in your book, underline this. Now, bacteria may have different shapes and on the basis of different shape, they have been given different names. First is cocci. Cocci means these bacterial cells, they will be spherical in shape. Example of a cocci bacteria is Streptococcus pneumoniae. By the name, you can easily tell that this bacteria is responsible for causing pneumonia. And in the genus name, you see coccus is there. So you can easily make out that this is a spherical bacteria. Then bacilli. Bacilli means rod-shaped bacteria. Escherichia coli, Bacillus anthracis, these are examples of bacilli, okay, rod-shaped bacteria. Then spiral-shaped. Spiral-shaped bacteria example, Treponema pallidum. And Vibrios means comma-shaped bacteria. Example, Vibrio cholerae. Now, this is the causal organism of cholera. Now, children, I have a picture where you can see bacilli. Here you can see three rod-shaped bacteria stuck together. Okay, they are sticking together. So, these are rod-shaped. See, cocci, many bacterial cells together, but they are all spherical in shape. Spirilla spiral shaped and Vibrio comma shaped. Now, if we study the structure of one bacterial cell, what all things we can find out? First of all, bacteria is a single celled organism, and as I told you, they are primitive, they are very ancient, age old, okay, so they do not have a definite nucleus. They do not have well-defined membrane-bound organelles. You remember, we have studied different organelles in the first chapter. So, well-defined membrane-bound organelles are missing in bacterium. The nuclear material, since it is not having a defined nucleus, so the nuclear material is scattered in the cytoplasm. Now, some bacteria may have a flagella or cilia for locomotion. The diagram that is given in your book there, you can see it has a green colored thread-like structure, that is the flagella. So, flagella, which is there in some bacterial cells, they help in movement, the locomotion. And if flagella is lacking, then hair-like cilia will be present. So, through ciliary movement also, bacteria can move. They can show locomotion. One very important thing to note is that bacterial cells have cell wall. Okay, we have studied that plant cells have cell wall animal cells it is missing, but in bacterial cells also have a cell wall. Although the composition of cell wall is different, but they do have a cell wall. And some bacterial cells may have a slimy material which covers the body, that is the protective covering, and it is known as capsule. Alright, so these are the important points that we must remember when we are talking about the structure of a bacterium. Children, now see this diagram. Here you can see the slimy outside protective covering, that is capsule. Then you can see inside it is the cell wall, then plasma membrane, and followed by cytoplasm and nuclear material. The thread-like flagella is also visible. So this is the simple diagrammatic representation of structure of bacterium. You have to draw this diagram. This diagram is there in your book also. So you have to draw the diagram in your FAIR notebook. Alright. I hope that till the portion that I covered, you have understood it very well. So you will go through it. You will read it properly. And you will learn the examples that I told you. And you will draw this diagram. I will continue with this chapter in our next regular virtual classroom. Alright. Thank you, children.